Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If this is your first time here, hi, my name is Sylvia. I'm a hairdresser, I've been doing YouTube for a very long time. And so there's been a huge request for me to react to hair fails. And honestly, the reason why I haven't done it yet is because I feel like I don't necessarily show how I'm feeling about stuff. Like I hate when someone watches me open a gift. I've actually more recently learned that that is a thing, and a lot of people have this. And so I just thought, you know what, that's not for me. Well, about 2 weeks ago, I just clicked on one out of curiosity, and within 3 seconds, my like jaw was on the floor. And I was like, I didn't actually realize that these things were happening to people. So as a hairdresser, I feel like this is going to be extra, I was gonna say entertaining, but it's not entertaining because it's actually painful. So basically in today's video, I'm going to be reacting to a compilation of hair fails, and hopefully if I see something that can easily be fixed or changed, I will give you my notes on that so that this video is also hopefully helpful. All right, let's start watching. Well, so
hair so fallout after right, bleach for 6 hours.
Oh my. Okay, whoa, I'm still processing the first guy. He technically wasn't doing anything wrong, but so fast, and the way he was doing it by like feeling it and knowing where he needed to go back was crazy. I just felt like he was either going to slice his scalp open or his finger. Now this lady, this was so much hair falling out. And the fact that he just pulled it out in front of her, I mean, I guess he wasn't expecting that to happen. Wow. So as a hairdresser in the 10 years of doing hair, obviously this has happened. I want to say only once. It was twice. It's happened to me twice. Never in that quantity. Holy, oh my gosh. I think as the client, I think I would just run and go wash my hair at home. Oh, it looked fine from the front. I was like, go her. She didn't have a fail. Oh, okay. So this describes every time a client that's like, I want some low lights. And low lights on hair that's already blonde is, I mean, you have to do it. A root smudge or root melt is always the way to go. And then kind of feathering it through so that you don't just have a disgusting streak from root to ends. And then the second major issue with this is that it's jet black. In no world would, I mean, unless you're trying to do like a fashion-y thing, but that's clearly not what they were going for here. So it's jet black next to like a level 10 highlight. So not only does that make the blonde just look extremely like damaged and dry, it's just, it's so unappealing to the eye. If natural is what she was going for, that is not what she achieved. Oh boy.
It's really not that bad.
They got the money piece right. In the front, it looks okay. Okay, let's see this next
it
girl.
It just needs a little shaping. To the salon!
Started with the hay. Wait, was that her hair at home and then she went to the salon to fix it? Or did a salon do that to her where like the back of her head is, or the back of her hair is just missing? Like if that's a bleach fail, I would be terrified and never ever step into a salon again if that was done at a salon. But maybe she did that at home and then she went to the salon to get fixed. I don't know. That totally just reminded me of a clip from Emma Chamberlain's video. She was like, her hair would also kind of have that same kind of chemical haircut in the back. And it was funny because she was like brushing it and she was like, why do I look like a border collie? I don't know why, but I was probably actually out loud laughing for a good 2 to 3 minutes. And I don't know why, but I thought it was more funny because we actually have a dog that's part border collie. Like, I don't know. That was what I was thinking when I was watching this girl. Okay, this next clip looks like it's someone that's about to bleach their hair at home. Lost a creaking, well, it just started in the hay. With his long
johns on, pop went a creeping up to the bottom to the hay. He doesn't know when to stop.
So the issue with that one, I think, is she bleached from root to ends. She was probably already blonde at the ends and just way, way over processed. And as you can see, she was doing that. Okay, this next clip, I can see that it's someone with curly hair. And typically this curly hair type is a lot more sensitive to bleach. It's a lot more susceptible to breakage due to the structure of the actual hair. So anytime I see bleach, and I already see that it's already been previously lightened, so this doesn't look great.
That's the second bleach today. Trying to tone it.
Oh no. When it's like, oh, it's not to the level where it even can be regular toned with an actual toner yet, much less with a purple shampoo. And those ends, which hasn't really shown us correctly yet, but I know that those ends are going to be gummy. So what that means is it's not going to receive toner. And even worse, or not worse, but with the purple shampoo, it's just going to pick up in specific areas. And the areas that are super yellow, definitely not going to pick up the purple shampoo toner. The purple shampoo, and yeah, that she needs a treatment. Not a purple shampoo at this point.
Doesn't work. Hair starts to fall out. Still has black spots. Coloring again. Red hair turned purple.
Okay, so also it looks like the hair has dreads, which bleaching dreaded hair. Basically, the bleach can't penetrate deep into the innermost part of hair in that like section. So you're always going to have some hair that didn't get bleached. So it's just never going to look the same. But because she said that this was the second time lightening, those ends were actually lightened pretty well. And that's why they're completely purple. And because that actually did tone. And then the scalp, which was still yellow, nothing happened. So basically what I said, it just looks like purple candles hanging out of a yellow base.
Green roots.
Okay, so they're adding more to the areas that are already purple, but also to the roots. What I would have done here is like a level 8, level 7 ashy kind of toner at the roots or at the base, and basically leave the dreads as is.
Wash, wash, wash. Toning it again. Literal dread falling out.
Wait, I feel like I just saw pink. Where did the pink come from?
Final product.
Okay, so the base color, I think they actually went in with maybe an actual toner this time, but the base color actually was... No, who am I kidding? It wasn't great. But considering how yellow it was, they actually got a lot of that yellow out. But yeah, there's no fixing those dreads there's no fixing the color without completely damaging those ends, because the only way to get that off would be to bleach again. But I absolutely would not bleach dreads again. I would remove them and then kind of start from scratch. So we have this guy here with fabulous hair in this weird curling, twisting contraption. Too high! No! Oh! Let go! Let go! What is this thing supposed to do? And she has like a piece of hair from each side of her head. I'm assuming it's like to braid, right? So you would want to grab pieces of hair from the same section so that that could braid. I mean, bringing it from two, you would have like a braid down the center. Okay, next girl at home. Color.
The smell of winter air. I see you standing there, covered head to toe in snow.
Okay, so it seems like she didn't like that she bled the pink color onto her dark hair, so she's grabbing like another section to add a little bit more of the pink. So she's bleaching now.
The snow is glistening.
Okay, that looked pretty neat.
Kettles whistling, onions sizzling on the stove. And I know it's just the start. It's not hope, but it's not very far. Hope I won't have a change of heart. But right now what feels true is I want to spend all these next days.
Okay, so far, obviously what she's doing is not very healthy for the hair, but based on the look I think she's going for, I think so far it looks fine. The key thing is it looks like she was also starting with virgin hair, which obviously you have just a lot more freedom to do a lot more to your hair because the hair is healthy.
Midnight.
By the way, she is beautiful.
With you.
Okay, very TikTok, very young. I think it's cool. I like that she like matched the eyebrows. The only thing I would have maybe been, the only area where I'm going to be a grandma about is the bleach that she used for the eyebrows. It's probably the same formula she used on her hair, which is way too strong to be putting on the face. And then she also like put on that like plastic, which you absolutely do not need on the brows. The hair is so fine and short that it'll bleach in 10-15 minutes regardless. So no need to put that, you know, plastic to kind of create more heat or even trap the heat so that the hair lightens further. But she did it correctly. She bleached before she colored. Now on, if you look at her ends, it's a little bit more peachy orangey. And I'm assuming that's because she didn't lighten as well as she did on top. So when she applied the pink, it just didn't show up as well. But other than that, not mad at this look.
Let me hear that boy. Let me get.
Okay, so I'm assuming she's gonna color her hair. She's sectioned out. Step one, great.
The most expensive car, and let me stare that boy. Real big, pretty city, shut down every city. If you want the kid, kitty, gotta get the kid for me. I knew everything, plus pay the rent for me. If we in the wilderness, niggas pitch a tent for me. Tent for me, tent for me, get me body. Long hair, no makeup, doing Pilates. Those niggas don't stop on my dance and naughty. All them pictures is my sons, but who's the daddy? I graduate with honors. I ball Nate O'Connor. I did a freestyle, then I got a...
So I'm assuming she was trying to get like a kind of looser curl. This is typical if you have a tighter curl, actually curling your hair with a bigger curl barrel will actually kind of like relax your curl. So I'm assuming that's what she was trying to do.
Shout out from Obama. Yes, yes, I am ill. I go.
So at least that one didn't look great. She didn't get the results she wanted. She's adorable. And at least her hair's not damaged. Okay. This next clip, anytime I see this on social media where someone is chopping the hair with a knife or an axe or a weapon and not scissors, why? Why? There's absolutely no reason. I think we've evolved enough that we have fabulous shears to be used. That's just so unsafe. And if I might add, it's not great on the hair because the speed that that's coming down, absolutely it's going to snag some hairs and then it just cuts because of, not chemistry, physics. You can tell I'm a hairdresser, not a scientist, but let's see.
No.
Thank you. and it's not even straight. I thought the point of this would at least be, like, you get to cut a huge chunk of hair in a very straight line. Not even doing that part right. And the fact that the hair is elevated up, when that hair falls down, it's going to look horrific. I hope they show us what that looks like. And also that cart. So many sanitary issues. So many. Oh, come on. I wonder if he cut around his ear with that same knife. What? Is he trying to, like, make it PC and point cutting with the knife? Of course he is. Yep, that's exactly what I was talking about. That elevation, no, the second she stood up, he's going to spend an hour fixing that hair, if he's a nice hairdresser. Okay. Oh my gosh, like, I just... Why? Okay, next one.
Okay, so we're doing a dramatic hair transformation today. Her ends are super dead, so we both agreed that it was best to just chop them off. And when I say her ends, I meant most of her hair. So we're really both excited about this big change. She originally
Okay, so far... Typical day.
Wanted to be an all over copper color, but we decided it wasn't best for her lifestyle since she wants to be more low maintenance. So instead I'm doing a teasy baby light, and this will give a similar effect and give her an all over copper look, but still keeping dimension so it's more on the low maintenance side. At the beginning of the year, we colored her hair in all over black. And as a result, this is how she lifted, which isn't a huge deal in her case since she wants to be copper. But I thought this was the perfect opportunity to show you guys why you should definitely think twice before having your hair colored permanent black.
Yes, I would tell my clients this all the time. If you ever want, if any of my clients ever wanted to go dark or black, I would always suggest to do it with semi-permanent color if they still wanted it. The same dark color a couple months later, we can go in permanent, but that's just what you'll have to deal with for years to come. And when you get that type of lift, the only thing you can do is you have to tone to the darkest area. So even though you lifted really well kind of in that root area, you have to tone it to as dark as the ends need to be toned.
For toner, of course, I'm using Redken Shades EQ, 6CR, 7C, and a dash of 8GI. I let her process for the full 20 minutes, and then I perfected her haircut, and this was the final result. We were both super happy. This is giving me very much fall pumpkin spice latte vibes, and she'll be
very pretty. Looks like we're finishing on a high note.
Back in about a month or two for a fresh toner.
So it looks like we finished on a high note. And I like that last one was almost a little bit educational. Also, my clients, sometimes if they were to see the lift and they'd be like, oh, I'm lifting so well. And then it's like, once you're done and you're toned, you're like, they would say something like, oh, it's not as light as it looked, you know, before. Why did you tone it so dark? And this video is the exact explanation of why you do, in fact, have to tone it darker. So anyway, this was a lot of fun. These were quite crazy. I'm sure there's way crazier out there. So if you guys like this type of video and you would like me to do this again, let me know. And I've also come across videos on YouTube where people are following one of my tutorials. And for the most part, they're pretty good, if I do say so myself. But I have thought about reacting to those videos, not in a shameful way, but again, to maybe explain what could have been done differently if there was anything that came out not exactly as they wanted. So, but yeah, this was so much fun. And so thank you guys for joining this video. And as always, I'll see you in the next one. Bye guys.